But for Britain, they're in against Ivan Lawler and Grayson Bourne. But now to the second qualifying heat, and this is in lane number three. Keep your eye on Ian Ferguson and Paul McDonald, Olympic champions for the past two games and looking to complete three consecutive gold medals in this discipline. And Ian Ferguson from Auckland, 40 years of age and in wonderful condition and a great heart. He really is a wonderful ambassador for his country and indeed for the sport of sprint canoeing. We'll get a closer look at the two of them in a short while from now. The other pair right next to them in lane number four to keep your eye on are the Germans, Kai Blum and Thorsten Gutsche, both from Potsdam, and they certainly are going to be a threat. There they are, just coming onto the pontoon. Interesting about that, they've switched clubs and they went to Berlin and they wanted to go back to Potsdam, and the German Federation said, no, sorry, you're registered with them and you can't go back. And anyway, it's been a bit of a funny time for those two, but now they're here on the pontoon. That'll all be completely forgotten. Second Olympics for Kay, and the first Olympic Games for Thorsten. And Kay with a bronze medal from the K4-1000 in Seoul. So already he's tasted what it's like to stand on the Olympic podium. So the lineup: Belgium at the top of your picture in one, then Sweden, New Zealand in three, Germany, Hong Kong, Australia, Portugal in the blue boat, and then closest to you in the brown boat are Finland, Mikko Kolimainen, with brother Olli Kolimainen. And remember, Mikko's already qualified directly in the 500 individual race. So away they go. Watch out for lane number three. The New Zealanders all in black. And at the moment, it's lane number four, the Germans, Kai Blum and Thorsten Gutsche, who've made the best of their way. And they have quarter of a length on the field. New Zealand about second at the moment, together with the Portuguese in lane number seven. And that's just about the leading three boats at the moment. Germans are pulling out a little bit more. And coming to half distance, Germany 1, New Zealand 2. It's very close, though, between the rest. 44, Portugal and Australia, who are in lane number 6, who were fourth in the World Championships last year. Only two to go through as we go into the final half of the race, and the New Zealanders are finding this very tough at the moment. They're being attacked on all sides. The New Zealanders in lane 3. Up above them, it's Sweden. Sweden trying to get there as well. They're in lane number 2. That's Carl Sundqvist and Gunnar Olsson coming towards the end of the race, and on the near side it's Finland, the Kolimainen brothers, who are doing really well. This is going to be very close for second place now, and it's going to be, I think, maybe the Finns closest to us. No doubt about the Germans, they're going to go through straight to the semi-final, and it's Finland who gets second place from Sweden, and then in a bunch it's New Zealand and Australia. So, very close there, 1:33.84, so a quicker run, but Germany, Finland, Sweden, Australia, and the Olympic champions are in the repechage. Only Germany and Finland to go through, so Sweden, Australia are going to go through to try again, together with New Zealand, Belgium, Hong Kong, and Portugal. And it may be that Paul and Ian will be more comfortable at the 1,000 distance these days than they are at the 500. Ian Ferguson, this is fifth Olympic Games, and so far the tally is four gold and one silver. There's Kai and Thorsten, Kai's second Olympic Games. He's got the bronze, of course, and he's had gold and silver last year in the World Championships. Torsten, also gold and silver in the World Championships. The silver coming for these two in this particular event when they were 0.34 of a second behind the Spaniards. So, well, that's the action so far from the regatta course at Castelfel. There's a few more qualification heats to go, but it's time for us now.